Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro and welcome back to fifth video of our Shopify Liquid programming series. And in today's video, we'll learn how the loop works in Shopify Liquid. In previous videos, we learned how to do the mathematic operations. We assigned a variable, we assigned a value to a variable. We worked how the if else work, how the logical operators work. We learned how the switch and case, in Shopify case works. And in this video, we will see how the loop works. Now, without further ado, let's get into it. So guys, to start with, I'll code the most basic for loop. So I'm zooming in and just so you can see better. Okay, so that's the starting of for, and we will end our for with end for. And in here, first we will mention our variable and then in, and then we will mention our range, what we need to print out. And then so basically it will print the range of numbers from 1 to 10. If we are not using for loop, we'll have to do it manually one by one, but in case of for, we just have mentioned it once within the for loop and it will print it 10 times and then end. Now let's save and see the output. Let's add a br as well, so it's on the separate line each time it's printed. Now hit save and go back and hit refresh. Here we go. As you can see, we have numbers printed up. 1, 2, 3. Okay, it's showing up on a corner. Let's add in number is. And add in H1 to make it more visible. Hit save. Go back to the page and hit refresh. Okay, as you can see, we have our loop showing up. Number is 1, number is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now there is one more thing in Shopify for loop. We can define what it needs to show on if it's number 1. Like the first index and the last index. So let me show you how that works. Okay, so let me give you the example. Now we will add in if condition in between that. If for loop dot first is equal to true. This is the first number. Else, it will continue the loop. So if when displaying the first number, it will display this line instead of the number, but after the first, it will display 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 as we printed on it here. Now let's end if. And allow. And now hit save. Let's go back to our page and hit refresh. Here you go. As you can see, on our first iteration, it says this is the first number, but rest of the loop is working as it is. We can also do the same thing with our last. So if for loop dot last is equal to, then we can display this is the last number. Hit save and go back to see how it works. Okay, as you can see, from number 1 till number 9, it's showing fine, but on last number, it says this is the last number, because within the loop we mentioned that if you find the last, print this, otherwise do this. So that was the most basic example of for loop in Shopify. Mainly what we use for loop in Shopify for is to collect the product titles, apply some styling, and let me show you one of the example how it works. Now what I'm gonna do, I'll print all of the products which we have in this store. So currently we have moment. So if we go on to the products, we can see that we have multiple products and we want to print all of the product names. So what we're gonna do, we can do this with for loop, and I'm going to go back in the code again. Okay, so I have my file open again, and now let's add in some code. Okay, so start the for, and then product in collections dot. In here, I'll mention which collection products I need to display. So my collection is newest products. And first, we'll find out the handle of this collection. So get into that collection and edit website SEO. So this is the collection handle, where we can access all of the products of this collection, and all of my products is within this collection. So I'll copy this handle and add it in our code. For product in collections dot newest products dot products. And then what we need from this collection is product dot title. Okay, click end for, now hit save. Okay, it's saying for, okay, sorry, we did a mistake here. We were supposed to add in the person sign and not the double brackets. Hit save, and now let's go back and hit refresh. Hey, you can see our product names are showing up. Let's add in the BR tag. So add in BR. So it's on separate line. And product name is add in H1, which will make it more visible. And it's safe. Now let's go back to our page and hit refresh. There we go, product name is new t-shirt, test product, blue t-shirt. So these are all of the products which we which the name is printed for. We can also pull up some other information. So for example, if we want to find out when this product was created, and so we can find out by this. So let's add in H3 for that, and product was created at, and we will add product dot created underscore at, and add another BR. Let's add in another info for published at. Product was published at. And to access that information, we'll just need to change this from published and hit save and see how it looks. Go back to our page, hit refresh. And here you can see that after every single product name, we can see when our product was created and when our product was published. We can also collect our product page URL. Product page URL is, so in here we will do product.url, and from this we can access our product URL. Here we go, it's displaying the product URL. Similarly, we have other options from where we can extract the product featured image. We can also get the product featured image name. We can also get the product image aspect ratio. So there are a lot of other things which we can do with the for loop. I'll put the link in the description for the detailed documentation from Shopify itself, so you guys can learn more. Again, that's the beginner level tutorial which will help you guys to learn about Shopify and do some basic level coding, so you can start customizing your theme and start earning through freelancing. If you like this YouTube series, do not forget to hit the like and comment and share, and don't forget to watch the next video. Have a great day.